Hello everyone, welcome back to Altium Academy. I'm your host, Zach Peterson, and today we're going to be talking about the two primary processes that are used to build PCBs with blind and buried vias, and that is sequential lamination and sub-lamination buildup. Now, this is part of a series we've been running lately about blind and buried vias, and today we're going to make the comparison between mechanically drilled blind vias and laser drilled microvias much clearer by comparing the manufacturing processes that are used to produce these. Now it's time to hop onto the whiteboard and get started. So in this video, we're going to be talking about the two manufacturing processes that are used to produce blind vias and buried vias in a PCB stackup. Now the first, which we have not talked about yet, is sequential lamination. Now in sequential lamination, essentially what we are doing is we are laying down sheets of dielectric material, and then we are building up HDI structures or microvias in the PCB stackup on specific layers. So this is the primary reason that we use sequential lamination, is for building up microvias in an HDI PCB stackup. The other approach, which we've discussed in some detail in the past, is sub-laminations. So in a sub-lamination, you're basically building up sub-stacks of PCBs, and then you are laminating them together using an adhesive, or using the prepreg as an adhesive. And then once you build up all of your sub-laminations into a full stackup, you can then drill your through-hole vias, and then you have your PCB stackup. Now the reason we use a sub-lamination process is to place mechanically drilled blind and buried vias. So in this process, we're basically creating our sub-stacks with our blind and buried vias, and then we press them all together into our final stackup, and then that's when we put our through-hole vias. Now, if you've ever looked at the structure of one of the standardized HDI stackups, you've probably noticed that you actually have a sub-lamination or a core buried via buried inside of a sequentially laminated PCB stackup. So you can basically have a sub-lamination that you then place your HDI layers on top of, and then you place the microvias into those HDI buildup layers. Now that's an important detail because it is possible to mix these technologies to some extent. And of course, you always have to get that approved from your fabricator before you just start mixing layers and technologies willy-nilly. But what we want to do now is just focus first on the sequential lamination process, and then we'll do a brief comparison with sub-lamination, and that'll help us really see what the limitations of the sub-lamination build process are. So first, let's discuss sequential lamination. Now, in a sequentially laminated build, we basically start with an inner core region. And it's not just a single layer, it's really a set of layers. And within here, we could have multiple layers. And so you can see here, I'm basically drawing out six total layers in our inner core. Now, this inner core could also have a via, which we then drill and plate, as you can see here. So this would be our buried core via, and then we have all of our other signal layers which can then connect to this core via. Now once we fabricate this, we can then build our HDI layers on top of it. So your first HDI layer will get laminated around this buried core. And so I'm denoting these HDI layers here in green. Now these HDI layers can then have a via placed into them. Now this is the overall process. First, we press the film onto this buried core, and then we drill using a laser drill, and then plate to form microvias in this HDI buildup film. And we do the same thing down here. We first laminate the buildup film, then we drill using a laser drill, and then we plate to form the HDI vias. So we have lamination, drill, and then plate, and then that gives us our HDI vias. Now, after we have done the plating process here, we can then laminate on another layer of HDI buildup film, and that allows us to put another layer of microvias into this stackup. So we would do the same thing. First, we would laminate on this buildup film. After we do the lamination, we would then perform laser drilling. The laser drilling would then allow us to then plate to form another set of microvias here on the top and the bottom side. So here we have our three steps which we perform in sequence. Again, we have lamination followed by drilling followed by plating. Now, of course, we can then stack these microvias on top of each other because we have this laser drilling process, which is actually very precise and gives us very good controlled depth drilling. So after we first fill in this internal microvia, we could then fabricate another microvia directly on top of it and stack them right on top of each other, just like you see here in this stack up drawing. Now that we've done all of this drilling and plating, what's the final step? Well, the final step before we would actually do this final plate that you see here on the surface layer is we could also add in a through-hole via, as you can see here along this edge. So here we would have a through-hole via, and this through-hole via could connect to all of the layers, and then it will get plated up during this final plating process that we use on these outer layers to then form these microvias. And that's basically it. That's the sequential lamination process in a nutshell. Now, the sequential lamination process is unique because it allows the stacking of these blind and buried microvias. Now, this stacking of these microvias is not something that you can do in a sub-lamination build. So let's take a look at the sub-lamination process and we'll be able to see why we're not able to do that in a sub-lamination build. So now let's talk about building using sub-laminations. So if we're building a PCB stack-up with sub-laminations, we would basically start with a sub-layer stack, such as this set of four copper layers that I'm drawing here. We would then stack these up as we normally would in the standard process, and then we would drill and plate, just like if we were going to be forming through holes in a four-layer stack-up. Now here, we've drilled and plated a via, and we could also form another identical sub-lamination down here, and then we can also drill and plate this sub-lamination to give it its own internal via. Now, once we form each of these sub-laminations, we can then laminate these together using some dielectric material. And so in this case, we would want to use prepreg because, of course, prepreg acts like the adhesive when we're building a PCB stack-up. So if we're going to bond these sub-laminations together, we would basically need a bunch of prepreg in between these two materials. Now, you don't have to use just a single prepreg. What you could actually do is use a stack of layers to then bond these together. So for example, I could have another core and prepreg stack here, and then I would have prepreg here shown in red. I'd also have prepreg here shown in red so that I bond to my sublamination. And then I can bond these two prepregs to a core, which is shown here in green. That would then basically require that we have a core here on this layer, and then we'd also have to have a core here on this layer. We would then have these cores bonded together here with a prepreg shown in red. We do the same thing down here. And then that would mean that this dielectric layer also has to be a core, as you can see here. Now, what if we wanted to then put a via that traverses through all of these layers? Well, then, of course, we could just then, again, drill and then plate. And then after we plate, that will form this internal via. And then this internal via will pass through and be able to connect to all of these layers, just like a standard through-hole via. So the process here is very important because the process for forming each of these layers is first to stack your dielectrics, then drill all the way through them, and then plate up that hole. Then you stack up things again, using, again, these prepregs and cores, and then you drill, and then you plate. So we have a stack, drill, and plate process. The difference here is that because we are using mechanical drilling, we're drilling all the way through this stack up in order to form these vias. And that's the central part of our stack, drill, and plate process. So for example, if we wanted to maybe, let's say, form a via from here down to this internal layer where maybe we have a landing pad, we actually aren't going to be able to reliably do that using mechanical drilling. If we attempted to do that using mechanical drilling through this hole, we would have to use very precise controlled depth drilling. Because remember, this thickness of this copper layer is essentially about 1.4 mil if you are working with 1 ounce copper, or it could be as small as, let's say, 0.7 mil if we're working with half ounce copper. Now that requires extremely tight tolerances on the depth of this controlled drilling process. And for those of you that know anything about controlled depth drilling, especially that's used in PCBs, typically the controlled depth drilling has a tolerance of somewhere in the order of plus or minus 5 mil. So it's going to be very easy for this drill tip to punch through this layer and essentially obliterate whatever pad you had right here on this layer. So for that reason, if we were going to do anything that involved just drilling a blind via like we would in the sequential lamination process, we would basically need to do that with laser drilling instead of doing this with mechanical drilling. Now, once we've formed all of these vias, essentially this stack, drill, and plate process can continue indefinitely. We can just continue building layers on top of this until we reach our desired board thickness. So again, I can put another layer up here. This layer would then be a prepreg layer. So I'll draw it here in red. And then once we put this layer on top of these vias, we could then, again, drill and then plate, and then that will form a through-hole via, assuming that this is going to be our final thickness for our board. And so this continues and continues until you keep building up these nested sets of buried vias inside the outermost via, as you can see here. So this is an important reason that we have some of the design rules that I've talked about in sub-lamination builds in some of the other videos. For example, here you can see that we have these vias that are basically nesting inside of each other. So here I can have a via that is fully enclosed in this other via. I can have two vias that start on the same layer, but they can't end on the same layer. I can also have two vias that end on the same layer, but they can't also start on the same layer. And that's how we build up these via spans in this sub-lamination process. But regardless, we can continue building up these sub-laminations as many as we like, and then continue to bond them together using prepregs, and then that's gonna form our final PCB stack up. Now, as you can see here with these sub-laminations, as we're building each sub-lamination, the drill that we have to use is going deeper and deeper through all of these layers as we keep building more sub-laminations on top of each other. Now, that's an important point to note because the aspect ratio limit on these mechanical drills is going to limit the drill diameter that you're allowed to use for each of these vias as you place them in the stack up. So here on these shorter buried vias, you could probably use a smaller drill diameter. For example, you could probably get this all the way down to 6 mil if you get it approved by your fabrication house. Now for these larger vias where you're drilling through many more layers and a larger distance through the whole stack up, this might force you to go all the way up to, for example, a 10 mil drill diameter. So you can't just use a 6 mil drill diameter here just because you used it here in this part of the stack up. Another very important point to note about this process is that each time you drill and plate, you are building up the plating on each of these layers where these vias terminate. So for example, you might have a starting copper weight of 0.7 mils or 1/2 ounce per square foot copper. But let's say, for example, we plate up a 0.75 mil thick via wall for this drill. Well, if we do that, then that means that this copper on this layer is actually going to get plated up to 1.45 mil instead of 0.7 mil. So remember, it starts at 0.7 mil, but we add 0.75 mil via wall thickness, and that gets us up to 1.45 mil. Now the same thing happens on these other vias when we then drill and plate this longer buried via. So if we have this buried via that we then drill and plate to a 0.75 mil via wall thickness, now this surface layer is not going to be 1.45 mil. It's actually going to be 2.2 mil. And you can see how that pattern is going to repeat itself all the way down this stack up. So each time you are going through and drilling and plating, you are adding copper onto these layers where these vias terminate. Now that can be very important because remember, here you started drilling through a 0.7 mil thick sheet of copper. But here, your starting drill is going to be through a 1.45 mil sheet of copper. Now why is that important? Well, that's going to affect the annular ring that you're going to need on these vias in order to comply with IPC Class 2 or Class 3 requirements. Eventually, when you get to having a large number of blind vias or buried vias through one of these sublaminations, you might actually be drilling through, for example, 3 ounces of copper. And that's going to really greatly increase the pad oversize that you need on these vias in order to comply with IPC Class 2 or Class 3. This is yet another reason it's very important to get your fabricator's capabilities before you start building up these sub-laminations, because each time you're adding new copper onto these areas where you're going to be drilling, and that will impact the pad oversize that you need to ensure that you have enough annular ring. Now, if you're interested in learning more about sub-lamination builds, check out some of the links in the description of this video. You'll be able to get access to a video where I go over how to use these types of vias for overlapping BGAs. I also go over some of the design rules for working with these types of via structures. We also have some great resources on sequentially laminated PCBs with blind and buried microvias. Make sure to check out those videos as well. Thanks for watching this video, everybody. Make sure to check out the links in the description if you want to watch some other videos we've created about blind and buried vias. And you can check out the article linked in the description to learn more about these manufacturing processes. Make sure to hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, leave your comments and questions in the comment section. And last but not least, don't forget to call your fabricator, folks. We'll see you next time.